Hello scholars, welcome back. Today we are going to do last chapter from our students book and very interesting story that how the moon and stars got their light. Okay, so let's start. We will read and I am going to explain you this, but it's very interesting. When you will read by yourself, you can understand that how much interesting story is this. Okay, so before starting the story, here some questions are there that where does the moon get its light from? Okay, so you have to think and you have to give answer here. How are stars different from the moon? That we all know, right? That stars are very small in size and moon is a big satellite. Then what are constellations? That you must read before, means in previous class. In science or in SS, do stars help human beings? If so, how? That we all know that stars and moons are helping us, but how? That you have to think and you have to write. Okay. Next is, yes, first of all, that once a time there was great scarcity of food in the land. A man called Anansi, the name of the character is Anansi, a man called Anansi and his son Kwekutsin were very hungry. They set out one morning to hunt in the forest. After hunting for a short while, Kwekutsin caught a deer and carried it to his father, waiting at their resting place. Anansi, who had also been hunting but had not been as lucky as his son, was very glad to see such a supply of food. Anansi then asked Kwekutsin to wait there while he went in search of a basket in which they could carry the deer home. An hour or so passed without his return and Kwekutsin became anxious. Okay scholars, so what is here in this paragraph? That Anansi, the father of the main character, the name of the main character is Kwekutsin. Okay, Kwekutsin. So they were very hungry and they were searching something. They were trying to hunt any animal. So but they were not getting any animal to hunt. But after some time, what happened? Kwekutsin found one deer nearby him. So he thought to hunt that deer and he hunted that deer. When he hunted that deer, he brought that deer to his father Anansi. And Anansi, who was also searching something, who was also searching animal to hunt, but he was not that much lucky. So he was not getting anything. When he saw that Kwekutsin got or hunted one deer, he was very happy that after a long time they got some food. He was very happy. But what Anansi said, that you wait here and I am going to bring some basket. We will keep this deer in that basket so that it will be easy to carry this deer to our resting place. Okay, so Kwekutsin was waiting there with that deer and Anansi went to bring one basket. But what happened after some time, when passed away, but Anansi was not came there where Kwekutsin was waiting for him. Fearing that his father had lost his way, he called out loudly, "Father, father," to guide him to the spot. Suddenly he heard a voice reply, "Yes, my son," and he immediately shouted again, thinking it was Anansi. So usually we all are doing this, right? So he was calling his father, "Father, father." He thought that maybe his father forgot, means not getting the same spot where he was waiting for his father. So that's why he called to give him correct path. But at the same time, he got some sound, "Yes, my son," like that. So he thought that his father is nearby, and he called his father again. Then a terrible dragon appeared. The monster breathed fire from his nostrils and was very frightening. Kwekutsin was terrified at his approach and hid in a cave nearby. He ran in such a hurry that he forgot to carry the deer with him. ओके सो वॉट हैपन नाउ when he was calling his father, at the same time one dragon appeared, a terrible dragon, means he was a very dangerous type, and he was in anger also, that dragon. And by watching that dragon, Kwekutsun was very terrified. He was afraid by seeing that dragon. So what he did, he hid in a cave. He went in a nearby cave and he tried to hide himself. And he ran from that place. But what happened? In a hurry, he forgot to take that deer with him. Then the dragon was annoyed to find only the deer's body. He vented his anger by punching the deer and went away. Soon after, Anansi returned with a sack. Okay, so what happened? Kwekutsun went to a cave and he tried to hide himself from that terrible dragon. But dragon found only one deer there, so he was in anger because he was searching something, means he was searching human's body. Okay, so when he got deer's body, he was in anger. He punched that deer and went from that spot. And after some time, Anansi came there with a sack. Kwekutsun told him about the fire-breathing dragon that had come and how he had to run for his life. Anansi was greatly interested in his son's tale and wished to see the dragon for himself. As soon as he had expressed his desire, the monster smelt human flesh and returned to the spot. He carried the deer off to his castle. Kwekutsen was surprised to find that there were many other creatures who had been held captive by the dragon in the castle. All the prisoners were under the charge of the dragon's servant, a fine white rooster, who always crowed to summon his master. If anything untoward happened, after leaving Anansi and Kwekutsen in the castle, the dragon went off in search of more prey. Kwekutsen wanted to escape from the castle and called all his fellow prisoners together to hatch an escape plan. Okay, so now what? Now Kwekutsen told to Anansi about that dragon, about that fire-breathing dragon. And when Anansi heard all this, his son's story, means whatever his son was saying, when he heard all that, he just wished to see that dragon. But at the same time, what happened? That dragon smelt human's flesh and he appeared again. That terrible dragon appeared again. And what happened? He carried both Anansi and Kwekutsen, and he took them from there, from that forest, and he kept them in his castle. There was one castle of this dragon. So this dragon took Kwekutsen and Anansi to his castle. And when they reached there, Anansi and Kwekutsen, what they saw, that there were many other creatures are kept there by that dragon, and all that prisoners were under the charge of dragon's servant. Who was the dragon's servant? There was one white rooster who was the servant of that dragon. Okay. And he was very obedient to his master. Who? Rooster. Rooster was very obedient to his master. Who was his master? Dragon was his master. So they were very, all prisoners were kept by the dragon in his castle. And he added two more, that Kwekutsun and Anansi. Okay, so now this Kwekutsen saw many other creatures in that castle and thought one plan how to escape from that castle. And he called all his fellow prisoners, means all other creatures, those who were kept in that castle, he called all that creatures and told them about one plan how to escape from that castle. Now, the other prisoners who had been staying there for many days were afraid to run away. They told him that the dragon's eyesight was so keen that he could detect a tiny fly moving miles away. Not only that, but he could move over the ground so swiftly that none could outdistance him. Quikutsin was extremely clever and soon thought of a plan. Okay, so now those who were from in that castle for many days, they were very afraid by listening that plan, and they told Quikutsin that it's very difficult to move away from this castle because the rooster is very dutiful and he is a very keen observer. Not a single fly can move from here and there because he can detect each and everything. They told about the rooster. So Quikutsin was also very clever and he thought about one plan. What was his plan? Knowing that the white rooster would not crow as long as he was eating. Quikutsin was knowing this thing, that white crow when they are eating they will not crow. So what he planned, Quikutsin scattered 40 bags of grain on the ground. What he did, he scattered 40 bags of grain. He got 40 bags of grain in that castle and he scattered all that 40 bags of grain in there on the ground. While the rooster was busy eating, Quikutsin told some of the prisoners to spin fine ropes to make a strong rope ladder. One end of this he would throw up to heaven. He was sure that the gods would catch it and hold it while his fellow prisoners and he climbed the ladder. Okay, so he had one plan that we will make one ladder. The prisoners, those who are there, he told to them that we will make one ladder and we will throw that ladder to the sky. And he was sure about this, that when he will throw the ladder into the sky, any god will catch it and hold it. And if any god will hold it, at the same time we all will climb to the sky. While the ladder was being made, the other prisoners collected some bones and gathered them in a great sack. Quikutsin also picked up the dragon's fiddle. The ladder was made and the sacks of bones were ready. The rooster was still eating the grains. It was time to escape. Quikutsin threw one end of the ladder up to the sky. The gods caught it and held it. The dragon's prisoners began to climb one after the other as Quikutsin remained at the bottom. So now what? They made one ladder and Quikutsin threw that ladder into the sky and it was held by one god. And the other prisoners, those who were there, Quikutsin gave them offer to climb the ladder and to reach the sky. And Quikutsin was waiting there. At the last, he thought to climb the ladder. By this time, however, the monster saw that something unusual was happening in his abode. He returned quickly. Seeing the dragon coming back, Quikutsin also climbed up the ladder with the bag of bones on his back and the fiddle under his arm. The dragon began to climb after him. Each time the monster came too near, the Quikutsin threw him a bone. The dragon was very hungry and he went back to the ground to eat and began climbing again after it had eaten. Okay, so what happened? Quikutsin saw that that dragon is coming again. So what he did, he started climbing the ladder, and the dragon, he also climbed up the ladder to catch the Quikutsin. But at the same time, what Quikutsin did, he had one sack, and in that sack he kept bones. Okay, he kept many bones in that sack. So whenever that dragon was trying to catch Quikutsin and climbing the ladder, at the same time Quikutsin was throwing the bones towards him, and as dragon was very hungry, he was again going to catch that bone. He was eating that bone on the earth and again trying to climb up to that ladder. During this time, what Quakerson was doing, he was continuously climbing up. And dragon was going to the earth, eating the bone and coming again to climb. Okay. Quakerson continued to do this till all the bones were finished. By this time, all the prisoners were safely up in the heavens. Quakerson then mounted himself as rapidly as possible, stopping to play a tune on his fiddle. Each time he did this, the dragon would return to earth to dance, as the fiddle produced magical sounds, magical music. When Quakerson was quite close to the end of the ladder, the dragon nearly caught him. The brave boy bent down and cut the ladder away. The dragon was dashed to the ground, but Quakerson was pulled up to safety by the gods. Okay, so what happened when the bones were finished at that time? What Quakerson did, he was making sound from the fiddle. He was continuously, he was trying to make sound from the fiddle, so that that fiddle was producing magical music. And by hearing that magical music, the dragon was dancing on the earth. He was going to dance on the earth. So till that time, what happened? Quakerson reached to the sky, and lastly, what he did, he cut the ladder. He cut the ladder, and that's why Quakerson reached. Quakerson was unable to climb again now, because there was no ladder. Ladder was cut by the Quakerson. So dragon was not able to reach or not able to catch Quakerson, and Quakerson was safely pulled up to the sky by the gods. The gods were so pleased with his wisdom and bravery that they made him the sun, the source of all light to the world. Anansi became the moon, and all other prisoners who had helped him escape became the stars. Since then, Quakerson gives light to the moon and the stars. Without him, they are dull and powerless. Okay, so after this, what happened? The god was so pleased by seeing the there were many gods in the sky, and they all were very pleased to see this bravery done by Quakerson. So they made him sun. All gods, they made Quakerson as a sun and the source of all light to the world, and Anansi became the moon. So Anansi is also getting light from the sun, means from the Quakerson. And all other prisoners, those who helped Quakerson to escape from that castle, all that prisoners, they all became the stars. Since then, Quakerson gave light to the moon and the stars. And without Quakerson, without sun, they are dull and powerless. Okay, so in last, we are getting the answer of our chapter's name, that how does the moon get light? So who is giving light to the moon? The sun is giving light to moon and to the stars. Okay, so scholars, try to read this lesson by yourself and try to find out hard words, try to learn word meanings, and keep ready this lesson for your exams. In next video, we will start something new. Till that time, take care. Bye bye.